This is a quick story about the Qatar Airways Airbus A380. Now, Qatar Airways have 10 Airbus A380s. I only cut out three, though, so this will have to do for the moment. When the A380 was launched, it was a technological marvel. It was celebrated as the future of aviation. But recently, Qatar have announced that, unfortunately, they're going to be retiring all of their Airbus A380s, which probably has a lot to do with the fact that 2020 came along and changed aviation for everybody. I hate you, 2020. So instead of the Airbus A380, Qatar Airways have said they're going to be focusing on the Airbus A350 and the Boeing 787 Dreamliner instead. But why did the Airbus A380 fail? And are the Airbus A350 and Boeing 787 Dreamliner really suitable alternatives? How do they all stack up and compare against each other when you put them side by side? To start off, let's take a look at range. This is how far your aircraft can go without refueling. The Airbus A380 can go 14,800 kilometers before it has to refuel. The Airbus A350 is pretty similar, around 15,000 kilometers. And the Boeing 787 is not too far behind at 13,800 kilometers of range. Just very quickly, of course, these figures vary depending on payload, configuration, etc. But it's just to give you a quick comparison. Okay, that's range. Next, how many passengers can they all carry? The Airbus A380, designed to carry more passengers than any other aircraft in the world, of course, comes in at a whopping 517. The A350, 283. And the 787 Dreamliner, slightly less. 254. Once again, subject to configuration and payload. Now then, the final thing you want to look at is you want to look at the fuel consumption. And just to get a little bit nerdy for a second, we're going to measure that in kilograms of fuel burnt per hour. The A380, with literally double the number of engines than any of the other aircraft we're looking at here, burns 11,000 kilograms of fuel per hour. I know, right? The Airbus A350 will burn 5,800 kilograms of fuel per hour, whereas the Boeing 787 Dreamliner is pretty equivalent to the A350, 5,600. Once again, that's based on fuel. Now, if you actually take the fuel consumption for each aircraft and divide that by the passengers that each aircraft can carry, the numbers you get are actually quite comparable. However, that all depends on one very important factor, which of course is you have to fill up the plane with passengers. This Airbus A380 is still going to consume a lot more fuel per hour than the A350 and the Boeing 787, even if it doesn't have 517 passengers on board. Now, there's no disputing that the Airbus A380, when it was first released, was, well, it was a technological marvel. It was the world's largest commercial airliner. It was quiet to ride on board, great for passengers. Some A380s even had a bar on board. And others had showers. But whilst you can't dispute how technologically awesome this plane was, you can't also dispute how hard it was to cater for. Take a look, for example, at the difference in wingspan. The wingspan of the Airbus A380 is 80 meters from tip to tip. The Airbus A350 is just 64 meters, and the Boeing 787 Dreamliner is even narrower at just 60 meters wide. So the Airbus A380 is at least 15 meters wider than either the A350 or the Boeing 787, and that causes problems when you come to things like, how is this thing going to fit in the airport? Airports had to be upgraded to cater for the new A380s. New air bridges had to be added into gates. Taxiways had to be widened. But despite all these upgrades in already crowded airports, sometimes the A380 was just a little bit too big.
Well, Commerce 563, Senate Sucks, it just hit us at Mike.
Attention all emergency equipment, respond call 3-2, taxiway Alpha and Mike. Attention all emergency equipment, respond call 3-2, taxiway Alpha and Mike.
Once we are all flying again, Qatar Airways are planning to increase their capacity to more than 53 million passengers annually by 2022. And as part of their ongoing environmental goals, they'd already announced plans to retire the A380 for good by 2028. But it will be interesting to see if that's going to be pulled forward at all. They've also announced that they're phasing out the entire Boeing 777-300 and 777-200 fleet by 2024. But I didn't cut any of those out for this video, so this model that I have will have to do for now. The Qatar Airbus A380 flew to 8 destinations around the world: Sydney, Melbourne, Perth, Guangzhou, Bangkok, Frankfurt, Paris, and London Heathrow. And as the A380 is slowly phased out from these routes, we can probably start to see more and more A350s and Boeing 787s taking these up instead. I really distinctly remember the first time I saw an Airbus A380. It was at the Avalon Air Show in 2009. I took this photo and I actually printed it out and stuck it to my wall because I was so excited to see what I thought was this whole new exciting phase in aviation. So it's odd to think just 11 years later, we're now talking about its retirement. I liked the A380 as a piece of technology, knowing that we could build an aircraft that could carry over 500 people with showers and bars on board quietly and safely through the skies was exciting. There's little doubt that the A350 and Boeing 787, they are the future of long-haul aviation. We can see so many airlines going that way. But it's still sad to see a piece of technology that was so advanced when it came out falling by the wayside after such a short time. But as a passenger, of course, I can see the reasons why it's happening. The 787 and A350 are incredibly comfortable aircraft to fly long-haul on. But these long-haul routes are probably not going to be fully occupied for some time to come as we come out of this pandemic. So it does make sense to move away from an aircraft that can carry 517 people on board to something that's a lot more economical. And as these routes do get more popular and people do start flying more, it just makes sense to actually put more of the A350s or Boeing 787s on those routes, as opposed to looking at aircraft that can carry bigger capacities like the Airbus A380. But despite the awesome technology, it does feel like the A380 was more of a prototype, a proof of concept, a gamble on the future of global travel, but a future that nobody could really have predicted. Let me know your thoughts on the Airbus A380 in the comments below, and also what do you think about it being replaced by the A350 and the Boeing 787? Thanks as always for watching. If you love your aviation content and you are new to the channel, do consider clicking on that subscribe button. It means a lot to me to see the channel grow. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next one.